Hello, my name is David Reinprecht, and I'm here today to talk about six efficient ways on how to build muscles. Okay, number one is calories. Now, calories is very important. You have to be in a surplus by the end of the day. Now, what that means is you have to eat more than what you burn. So I give an example. So let's just say you eat 2,000 calories, and by the end of the day, until you go to bed, you burn 2,000 calories. So that would get you back to zero. That means it's a maintenance phase. You're not gonna gain, you're not gonna lose. Actually, most people are in that phase without even knowing. When it comes to muscle gaining, okay, you need to be in a surplus. You need to have at least an extra, 500-600 calories by the time you go to bed. Because the body needs those extra calories to burn muscles. Of course, you don't wanna overeat. You wanna be like 1,000 or 1,500 calories over, because that would also cause, fat deposits, which is not the goal here. And number two, amino acids. Now, amino acids, let me tell you, amino acids is the most important thing. Without amino acids, nothing is happening. Amino acids is the building block when it comes to muscle building. Whether you get it from different sources, protein sources, meats, plants, whatever. But, I would also recommend to add a really good amino acid powder that has good amino acids, full of essential amino acids, and so on. Amino acid is a must when it comes to muscle gaining. Nothing will happen without amino acids. Cardio. Now, cardio, well, depending on your type, whether you're hard gainer or whether you're easy gainer. Now, if you're hard gainer, of course, stay away from cardio because, you need all those extra calories. You don't want to burn calories, when you go through the muscle gaining phase. Now, for people like me, if I do like 20 minutes, three times a week, I get away with it, because I'm an easy gainer. I just look at the menu and I gain 5 pounds. So for me, it's fine. So I would say, you can keep about 20 minutes, three times a week. That's plenty. Science has shown that doing some cardio actually helps with muscle growth as long as you keep it to a minimum. Number four, how often do I lift? Well, that's an interesting one too. And I had to learn the hard way because, we always think, hey, the more we lift, the more we train, the shorter the breaks, the faster we gain. Well, actually, no, that's not the case. The lifting is just as important as the break. Now, I would recommend to, depending on your schedule, of course, but the best way would be to really train, every 2 days. Train hard for 1 day, take off another day, and so on. If your schedule allows that, that's the best way. Train hard, take off, train hard, take off. It's the best for recovery. Now, number five, more or less weight. Well, that's an interesting topic because, it seems like everybody, has their own theory on how to gain muscles when it comes to weight. But generally speaking, you need to go heavy. You cannot gain muscles on light weight. The muscle has to adapt to a certain force, and once the muscle adapts to a certain force and you keep the same weight, then what's to adapt? There's nothing to adapt more. So you're not gonna grow, you're not gonna go to the next level. So you need to go heavy. Then six, the best style of training. That's also a topic where everybody, has their own theory, but really what it comes down to is, you need to do progressive overloading, which means, like I just mentioned before, you need to go heavy, change up your training, always go to a max out set, where you max out at between 4 and 6. And then what's important is write it down. I don't usually write down like every single set and how many reps I do. Write down the last set, the max out. Let's just say, bench press 300 pounds three times, okay? Now that would be your max. You write that down, and then the following week, or let's be conservative, let's just say 2 weeks later, 300 pounds, now you push 10 times. Now that's already an indication for you that strength went up. When strength goes up, muscles grow. And there's, and also one of my favorites is, the reverse pyramid or pyramid training or drop sets or supersets. Really what it comes down to is, again, train heavy, lift heavy, and then just switch it up. And I'll give you a funny analogy. If I'm around the corner and you walk out the door and I go boo, you're gonna be like, ugh. You have no choice because you didn't expect me, you weren't ready for that. So your body had to respond. So you had no choice, you know, the body had to respond. Now keep your training in the same state of shocking your system. As long as you can train hard and shock your system with, you know, different variation of trainings, the body has no choice than to respond to that. And responding means it has to adapt, it has to grow, and that's how you build muscles. Now, I mean, there's pretty much six, you know, important ways on how to gain muscles. It's not a big secret. It's very simple if you know how. And of course, nutrition is important. Thank you so much for listening. If this information was helpful, click on my YouTube channel, subscribe, give me some likes, because it helps me to, you know, build a better audience on YouTube. And yeah, if you know somebody who needs that kind of information to build muscles, feel free to share.